actually was, I had some history before I went into that. I was quite surprised. I'm not, as Scott said yesterday, I'm not famous as Scott said yesterday for anything. except getting on the nerves of guys on CSA2, because I was asking dumb question about the other two. I'm presenting products that I want to listen to, want to see. But so I was quite surprised that there was any attention actually for a VGA board. I thought that everyone would have done that yet. Well, it seems not to be the case. So that's why I'm writing some stuff here. The first thing we need to talk about is not how to double scan, but how the anti-CATV system and the VGA monitors actually work.
Yeah, good question for start. Do you guys use PAL in Germany?
We do.
Okay, so is there
but German outputs, we can get outputs, we could get outputs in Germany with the anti-AC system, and you can get anti-AC TVs in Germany as well. Mm-hmm. So I did most testing on anti-AC outputs.
Oh, okay, cool.
So we have to talk about the anti-CATV standard and about VGA. So VGA convention. We can't really call it standard because no one defines it actually. It's just a usual a standard that everyone uses. That everyone uses it and it has to be the same somehow. But there's no real reason for it to be that way, not another way. Quite strange.
It works.
It works most of the time.
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna have some general talk about how to convert video to the to Apple II video to the VGA, and last I will talk about the Apple II VGA, my project. But that will be pretty short actually. If we're going to NTSC, we have to split it up. There was a monochrom NTSC standard, pre-World War II actually. That defines general scanning and so on. And the cover standard was added on that later. So we have to, we're actually talking about two standards that form one standard. It doesn't make it easy. The first method that is shocking for those who have not seen a scope too often, we actually first define some voltage levels to represent covers. We only have black and white since we have a cover. So we define on a video signal line on this yellow composite video connectors that we have 0 volts to get sync, a sync signal, sorry, 0.3 volts for black, 1 volt for white. You actually need a defined load for that, so that's a resistor of 75 ohms that's loading the signal to ensure that voltages are correct. You don't need to care about that, it won't go out anymore. On the transmitter, they did it the other way around. They defined 1% of the transmitter power as white, about 56% of power as black, and about 100% as sync. This was mainly because you can see noise way better in black areas